Welcome back, guys. In this class, we'll deal about the balanced or restricting at fault protection of alternator. So, as you see, we have seen before the protection of alternators by modified differential alternator and merge press in the different techniques. And this is another technique which is called balanced or restricting at fault protection of an alternator. So we use generally this balanced protection for small generators application. Okay, for small rated generators, we'll use this application or small generator application, and then we'll use this protection, this only for earth faults. Okay. So we are only for earth fault we use this protection scheme. So this earth fault protection only we use. We'll use further about. This phase to line fault and phase to phase. Okay. So this configuration is designed to operate only for at fault only. So it does not operate for phase to line fault and phase to phase fault. Why we will see in now here. The circuit configuration in general is given like this. So this is the configuration of balanced or restricting at fault protection of an alternator. If you see carefully here, the stata phases, this is a stata 3 phase, R phase, R by Z. So comparing with the differential protection and merge press protection and modified differential protection, we have individual CTs, individual secondary CTs applied here. But these are N terminals are connected together with one single CT. Therefore, if any, this entire thing will be monitored by this CT only. Whenever there is a fault occur, okay, and this secondary is normally felt in the form of so the configuration is given like this. So when this this is the relay coil, generally this relay coil is a earth fault relay. So this is a earth fault relay used. So I said while in earth fault relay, the importance of this resistance. If there is a fault current occur more that which withstand by the CTs, then only if cannot withstand. So if the fault current which are generally not normalized with this R resistance, then this relay coil will be operated to reduce the fault to isolate the fault section. So this is the fault section we need to protect. And now whenever there is a change in, when there is a flow in current, when there is a flow in current in this relay coil, only this fault, this the relay will get operated. So for example, if a fault occur externally, let's say this is a phase to earth fault occur externally. Okay, so then this will be, so there is a fault occur here. Now what happens is, now there is a fault current playing in this direction, and now there will be fault occur here, and this current will circulate, say for example this is I1 current and this is I2 current. So there is no current is going through this. Why? Because the current I2 will be equal to, what are the current flowing for each section will be equal to this section. Therefore, as you know that I1 minus I2 will be equal to 0. Therefore, the coil will not get excited. Now again, if the phase-to-phase fault externally occurred. So the phase-to-phase fault externally occurred, then what happened is here. So current is flowing in this loop only. So there is no possibility to flow current here. Okay. So what are the current, for example, so all sum of the currents, if you take phase to phase fault, if you take phase to phase fault, all positive sequence and negative sequence will get nullified due to circulating only. So there is no possibility of zero currents. Zero current will not flow. So will not flow zero current, then only, so there is no flow of current, zero current in this coil. Therefore, this coil will not operate for the external faults. For example, if a fault occur, face-to-face fault occur internally. So the face-to-face fault occur here internally, and there is a flow of current. Okay, or in this face-to-face fault occur in these two phases, or face-to-face fault occur in these two phases. Only thing, when the face-to-face fault occurs, we have a positive sequence and the negative sequence, unbalanced component. There is no zero sequence component. Okay, so there is no zero sequence component. This positive sequence and negative sequence, unbalanced components, will nullify each other with a differential of 120 degrees. We already know that. Then there is no flow of current I naught to the relay coil. Since there is no flow of current to the relay coil, then the relay will not get operated. But in case of phase to ground fault, say this is a phase to ground fault. This phase to ground fault is connected with this here. At this junction, this CT will get operated. But for face-to-face fault, this CT will get least operated because these two coils will be excited by these two only. So when face-to-face fault only, these two will get operated. This will not get operated. When face-to-ground fault is getting operated, this CT will operate. If this CT will operate, there is a flow of current here. That is a zero sequence flow of current will be there. This flow of current is traveling through the coil. Okay? Getting the point? This CT current, flow of current, that is fault current, that is zero current. If the zero current is flowing through this coil, whenever there is a flow of current in the coil, then coil will get excited and is getting operated. So this is only applied for phase to ground or phase to earth fault in the fault section only. Okay? So in general, this relay coil is configuration to 10 to 20% of rated current. Okay? So this will be operated only to 10 to 20% only. This configuration, there is a making or the design of this relay coil will be up to rated of 10 to 20%. Not needed to operate higher rated currents. And then this is coil will, for example, this will protect about 80 to 90% of winding. Okay? So, this winding section, if the fault occur here, there is a drop here, voltage, you know that. So, the winding section will be, so what of the winding section? About 80 to 90% of winding section will be protected by this relay coil. Okay? This is about the balanced, why we call it a restricting earth fault beast? Because this operation, this fault is only for restricted to phase to earth fault only. This will not operate for any other faults other than phase to earth fault. That's why it is named as restricted earth fault protection. So this is about for small scale, small generated applications only. And now we'll go to the next section is about the next class. We will see the interturn fault. So up to now, we have seen the fault occurs in the phases only. So phase to phase and other fractional internal. But we have not seen the fault occur between the windings. Okay? So what happens between the windings if the fault occur? Okay? We will see it in the next class. Thank you.